best ways to map with radar is to keep running parallel profiles, the same distance apart one another, and starting as close as you can to where your baseline was previously. You keep a constant baseline and towing it at a fairly constant rate. And like I said, we practiced for a while, but the guy that did this data, he pretty much collected it all himself. He had his own speed, and that was fixed for each. He never changed it too much, and he went back to the baseline. And that's how you get the best data with it. So it's all based on the very kind of just diligent about doing everything exactly the same on each line. And one of the things that we're hoping to do is to get better location. The more closely you can locate each point, the better your data will be too. Because if you can have it down to within 10 centimeters with a GPS or something, you can really get amazing data. We space these 2 meters apart. For big geologic features, you want to keep it fairly coarse. And we filter the profiles with another program. Basically, what we did with this was try to find where the rock was more difficult for the radar to penetrate, which was probably something like limestone, and map the top of the rock, and where there were depressions in it that were connecting to the groundwater. And then he made a three-dimensional model of all this stuff. So this is his ultimate model. All those little dots are basically based on gridding the data. He had many more reflections back in the antenna than those dots, but when you process it, you average them to make centroids, as they're called, in a program called GIS, and then you make a three-dimensional model. And one of the interesting things is this solution chimney. Basically, this is a kind of like a pipe chimney that's, the water's either coming up it like a chimney or down it, like a gutter into the groundwater. But then there are some other large depressions that are much larger that are basically sinkholes that are forming in underneath this lead. So, or we're seeing these happening in a lot of places in this part of Georgia, even though we've got covered land, the limestone's covered. The limestone is still dissolving beneath the clay, or there are old sinks in it that have been filled with the overlying rock. And I'll talk about another application of this whole type of methods in a minute. But one thing that we did it on two different days, we did two different sets of data collection, and it got a little wetter. I don't think it was rain. I think the water just started seeping up underneath, and so it changed a little bit of the topography. We got better data from one day than the other. Okay, so I promise. But that's one way we're studying, adding to what's understood about the plumbing underneath, going into the aquifer using the radar. Another.